episode of The Pitch. A lot of things going actually on. Love Contras has been extended, like Rattitit. And Davies from Tottenham Hotspur. I want to get actually back a little bit to Rattitit. Because it was actually already rumored that he was linked with Manchester United. But the funny part is, I'm wondering if actually Barcelona extended his contract to keep him at Barcelona or just get a lot of money. Because what's going on? Because he has a clause in his contract that he can be bought out for 125 million euros. If you are thinking that he's willing to stay, and nowadays on the transfer market, I mean, 125 million is actually not much anymore. Well, for a football player, if you really want him, I mean, let's say like Pogba. So I have my something smelling here. You know what I mean? And Rattitit is a great football player. Does he fit at Manchester City? Well, the case is, of course, Guardiola is sitting there, and he probably still remembers him from the time from Barcelona. So, do I think I see it happen? Guys, I'll be honest. I think this summer we're going to have a new record of the highest transfer. And I'll put my money on Rattitit to Manchester City. 25 million. And don't forget also, Manchester United may be also interested. They're the richest club of the football club. I mean, they can lose their money. I mean, they have that kind of money. Also, Lukaku has, Koeman has said that Lukaku is already as good as extending, but not 100% certain. Yeah, what do you mean now? Is he now, you know, Koeman, you're so unclear on this. Lukaku, is he now signing, staying with Everton, or is he going? Because if you can remember earlier this week, I spoke about that with him, with you guys, about that he's saying he wants to play Champions League and wants to measure up with Suarez. At the same time, Koeman was actually linked to Barcelona because of his past and also having a home in Barcelona. So I'm having something like, yeah, dude. Also something shocking. I'm going a little bit back in time. We're talking here about 2010. There was this Brazilian goalie who was 26 at the time, 7 years ago. And what happened? He was already past season. That good was he was. We're talking about Bruno. And even a club like Barcelona was interested to hire him. And he was dating this model. She was starting actually in some erotic movies. Never seen of them, but you know, I'm just also having my text here. And she disappeared. And what came later out, he apparently killed her and fed her to her dogs. He said his sentence and now wants to start to play football. I mean, 33. And with that in your backyard, I know he did prison time. I know he did time. But is that really smart to go out there and play football? Put you in the middle eye. I would, if I was him, I know it sucks. And I know the case in Brazil is it like this. There's not much out there than playing football. If you want to earn a buck, you have to start playing football. So that way I understand it. But is this really smart if they did this? I mean, fed his girlfriends to his dogs? Are you serious? And you want to go out there and stand in front of the television? What do you think they do to you, dude? I'm just saying. I don't know. So that is my take on. Yesterday I spoke also about Vilena. I don't know if you remember. I got a little bit pissed about it. Rightly so. I got a lot of positive commentary about it. People agree with that. Now, he denied 3 matches and 1 one on probation, so, you know, he could get more if he does it again. Now they said 4 matches, and he still wants to protest because he wants to keep on the fight and going, so he still can play on the 2nd of April Ajax. And what was his comment? He didn't see him. If you look at the picture I put on, all right, I put on the thumbnail. It was actually kind of fun. He's standing next to him. What does he need? Glasses? My God. Seriously, I'm just asking you. If you are standing next to somebody, right? It's next to you. You can see the dude, can't you? Just saying. There's a lot of crap. And I think he just wants to get away. And he know he fucked up. He just don't want to admit it because he thinks he can walk away with that. Dude, I was watching actually a few days ago, this Netflix series, and that's called How to Get Away with Murder. You know, there was about criminal of no legals and education. And taught by a real lawyer. And that C was called also. That C really was the little bit, yeah, devil's advocate, little bit like, I would sneak away. God, my God, serious, just like that series. I'm just saying. Vilena, take it from me. If you wanted to play Ajax in a few weeks against Ajax, you should just keep your elbow where it is and not put it in somebody's face to somebody who's standing next to you. And trust me, if you can't see the dude, buy some glasses. You know, I think you playing with Feyenoord, you can easily afford some. Because trust me, if you can't see him, and if you can't wear glasses, fine, just do it like me. Get your eyes lasered. Sorry, but, you know, I think this is so hypocritical. If you're a real man, Vilena, if you really are, if you think you're really a man, just take your punishment as a man. Just saying. There's this thing, right? There's this saying going on. If you can't do the time, don't do the crime. I'm just saying. Thank you for watching. I'll see you tomorrow with a new episode of The Pitch. Later on, I'll be posting a review of the movie Kong, Skull Island. And, of course, I'll be back with a new episode of Rumble Wrestling. See you later, guys. A lot of vlogs coming this your way. By the way, I've got actually a calling to make. If you want to help us out, because we're really looking for subscribers on our YouTube channel. Number 1,000 of the subscribers. I know we're a little bit far away from that, but the number 1,000, get this. The number 1,000 subscriber gets a free GGA Sports Studio t-shirt. Totally free. And that's also for our Facebook account. On facebook.com/GGA Sports Studio. If you like that page, the number 1,000 person who likes it also gets a free GGA Sports Studio t-shirt. All right? Well, thank you for watching anyway. My name is Jan-Jaap Abbink. And I'll see you later or tomorrow. Okay? See ya. Bye.